Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us for another episode of Inman in Studio. I'm Lauren Walker. I'm Senior Director of Strategy here at Inman. And today we are going to talk to new agents. There's been a lot of conversation in our social channels about new agents coming into the industry at a very interesting time in the world, in the economy, in the market. And so to do that, I'm really excited to sit down with John Crabb. John is CTO and co-founder of Agent Image. John, thank you so much for being here for this conversation.
Happy to be here.
It's an interesting audience, these new agents. They have a lot of things to consider. We recently did our virtual event, and there was a lot of content, a lot of conversation of saying, okay, I can't host the open house. I can't do the networking events right now. I can't be out there in person. What do I do? And so you're the perfect person to talk about this, of using digital tools to differentiate as a new agent.
Yeah, no, it's a really unique time, especially for newer agents. And I think probably the most challenging time for them. I think it's been a challenge for a lot of people to adapt and adjust. But, mm-hmm. Speaking, kind of firsthand, talking to a lot of new agents and being around them and, virtually and online, different summits, different things we've done together, even with Inman. And it really, the open houses they would pick up clients at, or different ways they would acquire new clients or meet people, has dramatically shifted.
Yeah.
And everything's screens. I mean, that's really what it is now. It's everybody's glued to a phone or a computer, and very few, not nearly as much interaction in person as there was before. So.
Yeah. And so I think that what I'd like to do today is talk about ways that new agents can be really effective with the choices they make in digital tools. And one thing that you've said in the past that I've always thought about is the idea of running toward technology. Can you talk a little bit about what you mean when you say that?
Yeah, no, it's with technology and as fast as it moves, you see a lot of the time agents in the industry in general are either sort of overwhelmed by the amount of tech that's out there.
Yes.
And trying to pick the right technology to utilize and to work with, or they're worried about technology either replacing them or sort of marginalizing their portion or their part in the transaction, the relationship. And I've always been a proponent saying, technology's here. Even before where we are today, and where the world stands now, technology moves at such a breakneck pace that you really have to embrace it. And there's so much that you can pick up efficiency-wise, communication-wise, things like that, that you can leverage with it, that it's never something to be scared of. It's here no matter what. And I just tell people, run towards it, embrace it. Learn from your colleagues and from your own experience, what works, what doesn't work for you, but you can't be scared of it. And a big one's video, right? Because, you've got to be comfortable being in front of people on video, on Instagram Live, things like that. All social platforms, and a lot of people have an aversion to that, myself included. We were just talking about before this. It's like I'm not a, it's almost like either screen fright or whatever. It's like you have to kind of work to get over that and be comfortable, because that's how people are going to relate to you and meet you nowadays and create a connection with you, more than ever before. So it's mm-hmm. so imperative that newer agents and agents in general embrace that and adapt it and adapt to it rather. So.
Yeah, I think that's a great point. And the other thing to keep in mind that we were also just talking about is the world has become more forgiving. Mm-hmm. Authenticity has always been an important buzzword, but I think now more than ever, we understand what it means is that, you're going to jump on camera from your house, from your kitchen, and people are going to see your cat walk by and they're going to hear the kids in the background, and that's okay.
Think about how we were in the beginning of all of this, and you talk about COVID and stuff, but you think about how everybody is still dressed properly, everybody is so, still trying to be sharp and on point, and it's like, and you can see people's real personality and real sort of who they are come through more and more, because people are becoming more and more comfortable with the fact that it doesn't have to be polished, it doesn't have to be perfect. Everybody's a lot of time working from home or, things like that, so. I think it might have frozen for a second there. Hopefully you can hear me okay.
No, everything sounds good from my end. Thanks.
Perfect.
Yeah. So what's great about that you were just saying is this idea of leaning into the authenticity, and how does that translate into, their digital footprint, if you will. What should new agents be thinking about as they kind of establish their stronghold online?
First and foremost, I think first you have to establish a brand, right?
You've got
to you got to create a brand and a brand that's identifiable. You know, the sooner you do that in your career in general, the better, because anytime you don't, those are literally months and years you can't get back that somebody would have identified with you as a brand, because it's really what you are when you're out there. What will differentiate you? What will make you memorable? You know, and I've talked to a lot of agents these last few months about the ones who embrace technology, who embrace social media, are already doing it, are so far ahead. The ones who haven't are getting leapfrogged and passed by the people who were or are quickly adapting to it and embracing it. And that's kind of what we talked about earlier, was I say run towards technology. You know, the more, the quicker you understand what the medium now is for communication and for people kind of getting to know you and you being relatable to them, it's a huge difference with that. So I tell people, you know, establish a brand. That's everything, right? That's from logos, colors, things like that, which kind of go without saying, but you really need to create that identity for yourself. So as you're posting things on social media, or as you're, you know, you have your website out there, you have any sort of review sites or stuff that have your logo, before it was open house signs, right? And it was all those things too, but it was a lot more, you know, tangible things that people might drive by and see, or be in person and see, or pick up a flyer, things like that. Maybe those things aren't happening now, but your brand is that much more important because it's everywhere digitally. And it really is important to sort of establish that first, and then sort of be comfortable, you know, more and more with, like I said, being in front of people online and socially, and being genuine, you know, being authentic. We talk about authentic versus manufactured brands all the time, and people can read right through something if you think you're posting what you think they want to see, things like that. People get that very quickly. It's everybody's online so much now, they can see through a genuine brand versus something that's sort of, this is what they kind of is curated, it's what they want to see. You know, it's a mix of houses, it's a mix of your family, your dogs, your hobbies, things like that. You never know what somebody's going to connect to or relate to, and it's huge.
Yeah, and they're trying to create those personal connections, you know, in a digital way. And so what do you suggest for new agents when they're thinking about, all right, I have to establish this website. What do I want from it? What does it need to do for me today versus what I'm going to need it to do maybe in 2 to 3 years?
You know, for that, just make sure it's professional. I mean, it sounds so simplistic in a sense, but whoever you use to build your website, back in the day, people were like, ah, oh, it's kind of an afterthought. I have a website, you know, maybe nobody will see it. You know, maybe they'll see it. People didn't really understand the importance of it. And I would get that. I kind of see, because they're so busy with everything else that, you know, but that's now literally the cornerstone of everything.
Yes.
It's what people are going to look to when they want to learn about you. It's where you can present yourself and control the narrative. You can control your reviews. You can control the video and the presentation of what they see for you as the expert of your community. There's so much that goes into that, that if it's not housed professionally, if it doesn't really emphasize your brand and convey that properly, it's such a lost opportunity, and it does cost people business, because if you have an unprofessional website that doesn't, that sort of looks, or it looks like everyone else's, and it doesn't portray you as somebody who's unique and stands out in this day and age, it's a shame, because it's truly something that people are going to, you need to be memorable. It has to stand out. It has to capture their attention within a matter of seconds. And it's so imperative, and it doesn't have to be an expensive website. That's the other thing too. People sometimes get sort of like, okay, well, if I want a site like this top agent, that top agent, it's going to cost me a fortune.
Right.
There are things out there that you can own as a website that are under $1,000 if you're a new agent starting out, that are absolutely beautiful and will brand you beautifully. And again, that goes for us and other products that are out there. There's so many options to look at.
Sure.
I'm just a huge fan of something that really houses everything you can tell and share about your story, about you as the expert of your community, and sort of why so much choose to work with you and why so much should want to get to know you.
I was talking about the idea of owning your website, right? And that these new agents come into the business, maybe for a large franchise, and they're handed a tech stack.
Yep.
And that might include a pre-made website. That sounds kind of perfect for a new agent to just hit the ground running. What should new agents be thinking about?
You know, there's pros and cons. I think if you just need something up real quick that gets you a site up, right? When you're starting out, you're newly licensed, you need something, it's not a bad option. You know, to me, I think what you need to think is past that. Where do you want the website to take you? You know, if you build up a following, if you build up, you know, search engine place placement in Google is still extremely important. You want to own a website for that, just because if you didn't and you decide to one day leave that brokerage or something changes in your career, you know, I've seen horror stories of people who had a website tied to a brokerage or tied to another vendor, and they go to move it and they can't take it with them. And all of a sudden it's costing a fortune, sometimes even more than the website, to actually migrate over all that content and do everything. You really should own your site from day one. And if not, you know, if the broker template or something provided, there's a place for that. If it's something you just need something up, like I said, real quick in the interim to get you going, and you've got so many other things on your plate, it's not the world's end. You know, there's most of the brokerages now have pretty enough ones out there that'll get the job done initially. But as soon as you can, and you have the ability to create something for yourself that's yours, that you can take with you throughout your career, you absolutely should. And I think everybody kind of knows that at this point in the industry, it's sort of second nature. I don't think people thought about it as much maybe 5-10 years ago, but more and more, even the major brokerages we talk to that were, you know, preferred vendors for and stuff, they like the idea of the agent owning their site, because it's something that they can sort of say, hey, we're not here to lock you into a site or anything. We'll provide one. And, you know, if you need something more than that, you know, here's Agent Image, or here's company XYZ that can help you. But just always try and make sure you own your site. It's something that's kind of near and dear to my heart, because I've seen the alternative for it and the stories that go along with it. So,
yeah, absolutely. All right. So let's go to the next step in kind of the agent's life cycle. You know, they're establishing their stronghold, their digital presence. Now they're going to go and pitch themselves, you know, to a client in the listing presentation. Where are the opportunities for new agents to really differentiate in that experience?
You know, it's interesting, because if you're a newer agent, you've got, it's sort of this dichotomy where you've got, are you dealing primarily with buyers, right? Because most newer agents are dealing with buyers a lot of the time. And if you're dealing with potential seller, because that'll happen too, you'll come across somebody who might be selling their home before they're buying their home, and you've got a couple opportunities, things like that. There's a lot to this, but you want to stand out as much as you can. Initially, you might not have the resources to build something that's more of like a custom listing presentation, which sort of, this is a whole rabbit hole in itself from a conversation standpoint, but you know, where the industry is headed, you're going to see a lot more of these virtual listing presentations, things like that. We're building a thing right now called Access, which some people who are watching this probably already heard of. It's gotten a lot of press through Real Deal, through Business Insider, Wall Street Journal, stuff like that.
Sure.
But we're trying to build something where, from a listing presentation standpoint, what I've seen for years, and it's been kind of the story forever, is the brokers provide a lot of these packages. But the thing is, if you're with the same broker, just three other agents who are on that listing presentation, your personality can absolutely be the difference. The collateral you bring might have a few pages that are different. You might have certain elements that are different, but once you leave, if that, you know, potential seller is left with a stack of, you know, coffee table books that all look the same, or that are, you know, there's nothing unique about them, then everybody's just sheep at that point.
Yeah.
So to me, it's like, how do you build something that's memorable, that's digital, things like that, that people can forward around, you can, you know, sort of, you know, see who's looking at, see who's opening, things like that. And there are things in the market that are out there, but when we set out to do that, our idea was, how do we build something that puts the control back in the agent's hands? Because that's what we saw a lack of. We saw so many agents that had a, you know, sort of a fear of, again, technology passing them by, all the major portals, things like that. But what's really cool about now is that there's so much the agent has information-wise. This almost goes back before broker reciprocity and IDX ever happened, where MLS listings were shared. It's gotten to a point where the ability for the agent to provide information to the consumer is so different than it ever has been before. There's so much more they can provide than a lot of these sites, because they're all MLS-driven. So all of a sudden, you can provide a lot more information to the consumer than these other sites can. And that is sort of the idea behind we created this, is how do we build something that's branded to the agent? The agent's brand is front and center. It's truly unique, truly memorable. So this goes, you know, it's more, I would say, for the newer agents starting out, separate yourself from the pack, you know, try and do something different. You know, what we're building will be out towards the end of the year, first of next year. But in the interim, whatever you can do, if you're a new agent, you're creative. Like, think of creative ways to differentiate your listing presentation, or how you send information to buyers. Over what's being done now, you know, especially buyer's agents. I mean, think about it. They're usually relegated to whatever the broker brand has to send out these, you know, these shots of property.
Right.
Or maybe they're sending some videos off the phone, things like that. Until the products we're putting out there, things like that come out, right now, whatever you can do to sort of differentiate how you send that information to a buyer, you know, that's huge, because, you know, that's what really, it's being creative and doing something to set yourself apart from what's already being done out there. That's what I would say first and foremost. The internet's a great leveler. You know, if you look at even our portfolio of all these top agents, I've got newer agents who've literally done a deal or two that their website and their brand looks every bit as established as someone who's been in the business for decades. And that's what the internet enables newer agents to do. And it's so fascinating to me, because never in the history of this industry has anything existed like that, where you can have your marketing be on par with the biggest celebrity names, the biggest agents in your market. You can create something that looks like you've been doing this forever, you know, and through, again, IDX and stuff, and that's out there, you can have an inventory and a complete site that looks like you're the expert and have been doing this for a long, long time. So.
Yeah, no, that's for sure. And it's so exciting to see when agents really use those tools to make such a presence built so shortly upon getting into the market. One of the things you were just saying, John, about being creative, I feel like we touched on open houses earlier, right? Because new agents, it's kind of traditional. All right, you're going to sit some open houses.
Yep.
And that's where you're going to get some folks who are looking and don't have an agent yet. But now they can't do that. Mm-hmm. Or in many marketplaces, they can't do it yet.
Yep.
What would you suggest? What are some creative ways they can pivot digitally in the meantime until those avenues are open to them?
From a standpoint of like generating business and leads and things like
yeah.
that.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I was having this conversation with the agent just last night, actually, and we were chatting about, you know, when this whole thing hit, COVID and everything, she was sort of, you know, everything just stopped, right? For
yes.
a few weeks, the world just stopped. And, you know, she had 120,000 commissions on the table to go out the door. I mean, she was like, this is my family. This is everything. Like, how am I going to react to this? And it was social media for her. And she'd started doing social media prior to COVID, before any of this. And she said it was amazing how she said, I'm just going to embrace this, go full force at it, and be really present and network and do everything through social media. And that was her way of doing it. And it changed her whole business. And so I'm a huge proponent of social media. It's an extremely inexpensive, free/inexpensive, even if you're doing boosted posts, things like that, to really get your face out there, to stay relevant, to stay present. If you're a new agent, it's one of the only ways you can do it when you think about it. I mean, you can do lead generation from, you know, paid marketing on search engines, things like that. And I would definitely say anybody who has the budget to do it, I would encourage them to do it. But it's one of those things where social media is huge, to actually be out there among your friends, among the community. She had a funny story about her Peloton group, of all things.
Oh my goodness.
She's generating tons of referrals through her Peloton group through, you know, and it was ridiculous how many, actually. So, I mean, these are the most random of ways, right? But whenever, again, in history, could open houses completely shut down, and you can be on an exercise bike and chatting people and doing deals all over. She was working referral deals from agents in other, completely other areas of the country. It's unreal. So don't think locally. Like, you almost have to think globally now, because the beauty of technology and the internet is that there are ways to network all over, and there are ways to do a ton of referral business all over by just developing relationships. And, you know, before you develop relationship through, you know, whatever it was, through coffee shop meeting or,
right.
you know, open houses or, you know, caravan with other agents or stuff, or, you know, when you guys do Inman, right, you do Connect or any of those things, and you have these different, you know, sort of forums for it. But technology has enabled agents to do that 24/7, anywhere, anytime, you know, not just, you know, centered to events or, you know, a summit here or there, or, you know, a convention, but you can now network online anytime, all the time, 24/7. And for newer agents, it's a no-brainer, because it truly is, if you're creative, it's limitless what you can
yes.
do for free, basically. And that's about as good as it gets when it comes to marketing. So
that's for sure.
That's a huge thing to recommend.
I love it. Yeah. And what's so funny about that, John, is, you know, you and I have talked several times and we're always talking about local. We're always talking about, you know, work local, you're the local expert, and local still matters. But the fact is that you just said think global.
You do. You have to. I mean, you really do, because, and it's true, you want to be that expert locally, you want to be that person, but that's going to happen as a byproduct of what you're doing on social anyways, in your community. You know, you can be active on community forums, be out there, just be out there, because if you're out there, if you're not out there, nothing's going to happen. I mean, I can tell you that right now, because that's where we're at. But if you're out there, it's the best thing you can do. Just, again, make sure your brand's on point, stuff like that. But end of the day, there's so much opportunity globally, like I said, for this, not even just domestically, but I mean, everywhere. People are looking to move, people are looking to relocate, they're looking for second homes. You know, and in this era, people are looking to move out of crowded cities sometimes to different areas. There's so many opportunities out there. It's just grabbing them and taking hold of them. And again, just not being scared of it.
Well, that's exciting advice for a new agent who's looking at some unprecedented times out there. And I think you've left them with some good inspiration. Anything else that you want to tell a new agent as they set out on their journey?
You know, we covered a lot, actually, in a short amount of time. I know it's daunting right now. That's the one thing, because again, I have friends who are newer agents starting out. I have, you know, not only that, like past colleagues, people, you know, obviously clients, but I know it's like this time that for newer agents, it's kind of like, okay, I just started out here and I got the rug pulled out from under me. Man, I was already going to be a challenge to start out, because it always is. You know, it's that first transaction, that first deal, it's like nerve-wracking as can be. You know, I've been on that side of it, you know, 20 plus years ago, but I have been. And it's like, you know, this just added another layer of complexity maybe to it. But again, it added so many layers of opportunity. And that's what I, you know, it's you can either be frozen or sort of, you know, be like, okay, did I make the right decision in this career? But there's so much opportunity. You did make the right decision. Like just go at it. Don't be scared. Like, to me, whatever it takes, right? That's always been our motto since we started 20 years ago. It's, you know, to be that, you just have to sort of play the cards you're dealt. But it's not a bad hand, man. This is like, it's not ideal times from, you know, a lot of businesses. It's a coin toss, right? Some are faring well, others are gone. And, you know, that be grateful you're in an industry where it's moving. You know, I talked to agents all over, and that first few weeks of this was replaced by just a boom in business.
That's for everywhere. Sure. Yeah.
And, you know, so it's a great market and a great career and a great industry to be in. You just have to be creative in how you market yourself. You've got to be memorable. I can't, you know, say that enough. Whatever you do with your brand, be memorable, be yourself, be genuine, and people are going to buy into that. And if you're out there and you're, you know, you're in front of technology and you embrace it, it's your friend, and it's going to turn out all right, and it's going to go well. So yeah, to me, social is the way to go, first and foremost, and just being present in your community through whatever ways that is virtually nowadays. I have so many funny stories. That person I spoke with yesterday, her kid was actually getting deals for throughout the neighborhood through his friends talking on Zoom and stuff. There were so many funny stories to this when in this conversation, but he's like, yeah, my mom's a real estate agent. You know, they asked me to do it, and it would just lead to these conversations. You never know what leads to a transaction, and there's this, opportunities are limitless. It really is when you think about it, and the playing field is huge. So
that's exciting. So run toward it, right? We come back full circle, run toward it.
Yeah, run toward it. Like, that's it. It really is it.
That's great.
It's, you know, and if they know where to find us, I mean, if they want, they can always find me. If anybody's got questions, I'm happy to answer it and help with that stuff. And
perfect.
You know, the website or not, if there's something I can help with you guys, I'm always here, you know that. So
yeah, absolutely. Well, as we wrap up, John, when can we look for that listing presentation tool? What's the status on that?
Whoops, it froze a little bit there, Lauren.
Sorry.
I lost you for a second. It froze a little bit. What were you saying?
I was just wondering when folks can look forward to the new listing presentation tool.
Oh my gosh, that and the, I don't even call it a virtual open house tool, because that's the part that was built off of this thing almost by accident, but it's turning into probably being a way bigger thing than even the listing presentation part. It's crazy. This, our goal is to basically house really all the cool tech that's out there in one spot, plus a whole bunch of features that people need, while also creating a branded tool for newer agents and buyer agents they've never had before. So that piece on top of the listing presentation tool, all that, should be out, I'm going to say, and it's already in beta with a couple teams, but it'll be out around Q1 next year, early Q1, if not the end of this year. So, but it will change the industry. You know, we've talked about it internally. I've seen what it can do, and I've done this for 20 years. It will revolutionize a lot of stuff. And it's what it should have been when people have tried to create it. It's branded the right way to the agent. It's got so many options when it comes to branding different teams and stuff. It's truly limitless what you can do. So nobody should look alike, which is always my pet peeve. Everybody should be able to walk in somewhere. It's a million different elements to it. It's crazy. I won't explain it here. We'll do it another time.
We will do it another time because that's going to need its own conversation. So I'm excited about that.
Yeah. So that's, this is fun. This is a fun conversation.
Great. Yes. Thank you, John. We really appreciate you taking the time to share your expertise.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Lauren.
All right. Take care.
All right. Take care.